So, it's getting festive up in here. I just got back from Disney World, so this hat may show up in several videos, because, I mean, look at it. So this book tag is called the Grinch Book Tag, and without further ado, let's get grinchy. The first one is, half the lights on the Christmas tree are burnt out. Name a book or series that started out good, but went downhill. So, there are a couple that I could probably choose, but I'm going to throw it back to a book series that I read probably in late middle school, early high school, and that was the What Happened to Janie series. So, if you remember, it started with the book Face on the Milk Carton, which was really interesting, and there were, I think, three books there for a while, and all of a sudden, she released a fourth one, and it just didn't make sense. And it was like the beginning of the series was really interesting, but then it started to sort of lose the stuff that made it interesting in the beginning. And it just got weird and sort of like all of this bad, crazy stuff and these weird coincidences can't happen to one family. It was just strange. And I was not a fan of the way that the series progressed. Your annoying Great Aunt Sally just won't leave you alone. Name a book that you didn't really enjoy, but everyone else seemed to love, so you just can't get away from it. Yeah, Maze Runner. Your pets keep knocking over the Christmas decorations. Name a character that just kept ruining things for everyone, and you can't pick a villain. So, this one I sort of had trouble with, and also reminded me that I don't keep books I don't like, because for the first three, I don't actually own the books that I am mentioning. And this one is no exception, and it is The Last Girls by Lee Smith, and the character Baby. In the book, she's not actually really present, but they tell a lot of stories about Baby, because that's sort of part of the catalyst of how the story, how they ended up on this boat, reliving this journey that they had when they were in college. But when they tell stories about Baby, there's nothing likable about her. And she basically just keeps, you know, screwing over her friends and, you know, putting herself before everybody else in the worst possible way. And she's just a terrible character and she messes up everything. And I think she might be a large part of why I really didn't enjoy that book. You hear your parents putting out the Christmas presents and you learn that Santa isn't real. Name a book that you were spoiled for. So I was in college and I was sitting at a soccer game and this girl, she was sitting two rows in front of me talking to somebody and proceeds to just at the top of her lungs announce that Dumbledore died at the end of book six. And I was still in the middle of reading book six, so I didn't know that yet. I swear to you, I almost came across the bleachers at that girl. I screamed, "What is wrong with you?" And everybody turned and looked at me, and I was like, who talks about that at a soccer game? And yeah, so I was definitely spoiled for book six of the Harry Potter series, and I was pretty ticked off about it. It's freezing cold outside. Name a character you just couldn't connect with. I would have to say the main character in Northanger Abbey by Jane Austen, and I don't remember her name because I did not like Northanger Abbey, and I know a lot of people love that book, and I've actually heard people say it's their favorite Jane Austen book. I couldn't connect with that book at all. Mariah Carey's All I Want for Christmas Is You is playing nonstop, and it's giving you unromantic feelings. Name a couple that you just didn't like. So first of all, now every time I hear Mariah Carey's All I Want for Christmas Is You, I think of my ex-boyfriend because he was obsessed with that song. I don't know why, but he was. So it does give me unromantic feelings. I would have to say, and this one's going to be funny because I don't know that a ton of people have read enough of the D'Artagnan romances to even have any clue about this. The King and Louise de Valerie I think it starts in the Vicomte de Bragelon and then continues through Louise de Valerie. They're both by Alexandre Dumas. their relationship just ticked me off. Because A, I love the Viscount de Bragelonne. He was my favorite character in like those middle books. I thought he was fantastic and I loved him. And I was really angry with the way that he was treated by basically everyone, and especially by Louise and the king. And so I hated that relationship. I thought it was unrealistic, one, because the way that they sort of get together is stupid. And two, I just couldn't deal with how they treated Raoul after they got together. I just thought it was awful. The scratchy homemade sweater that you got for Christmas years ago, but that you just won't get rid of. Name some books that have been sitting on your shelves you haven't read that you haven't read, but you won't get rid of. The first one is The Poisonwood Bible by Barbara Kingsolver. I've heard great things about this, and I really want to read it, but I just don't have the motivation. The next one is The Ha Ha by David King. And I think I got this through Book Mooch, and it was one that at the time I really, really wanted. But I've had it for probably over 3 years, definitely over 3 years, and I still haven't read it. And I remember being really excited about getting it. I don't even exactly remember what this is about, but I still want to read it because I remember just being excited about it. The next one is Walden and Civil Disobedience by Henry David Thoreau. I definitely have been wanting to get to this for several years. I've started a couple of times, but it's a little dry, to be honest. I really, really want to read this because I think that once I start getting into it, I'll really enjoy it. But it's been a trying task to start, and it's definitely not at the top of my list of want to reads. And then the last one is A Heartbreaking Work, A Staggering Genius by David Eggers, I don't know. I've also heard really great things about this, and I want to get to it, but it's another one of those that I just haven't found the motivation to read. Definitely, if you guys have read any of those books, I would love to hear your thoughts on them in the comments, because any little bit of motivation to read them would definitely help. Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer. Name a character in a book or TV show that you are still not over their death. These are definitely spoilers, so we'll go ahead and say that. The first one is for Harry Potter, and it is from the 7th book. I still am not over the fact that they killed off Hedwig. I know that's silly, but I'm not. I understand why they did it, why she did it, but at the same time, I felt like there could have been other ways to, you know, isolate Harry or whatever. I'm still not over Hedwig dying, and I'm also not over Fred dying because, I mean, they're twins, come on. That's just not right. So the second book one is from Game of Thrones, and it's from the first book. So if you've read past the first book, you already know. But I have only read the first Game of Thrones book, and you get attached to characters, and that was when I was naive and didn't know that George R.R. Martin likes to kill off characters like they're not important. And so I got really attached to Ned Stark, and then he died. And I was kind of pissed. And part of the reason I haven't continued on with the series so far is that I am still not over the fact that Ned Stark got killed. So the mall is overcrowded with way too many shoppers. Name a series of books that went on for way too long. That would definitely be the Animorph series. Another throwback, but yeah. When I was in middle school, read a lot of the Animorphs books, but it got to the point where there were just too many of them. I think there was like 58 in the series and then like 10 spinoff ones or something. But it was just, there were too many, and yes, they're small, but like 58 books in a series is insane. So the last question is The Grinch. Name a character that you hated. So I was like, I don't think I've ever hated a character, and I thought about it, and I thought about it, and I thought about it, and then it hit me. Man, could I not stand Holden Caulfield from The Catcher in the Rye. He is single-handedly one of the most annoying and just stupid characters ever. I read that book in high school I chose it. It wasn't something that was assigned to me, and I read it and did like a report on it. And it was a miracle I made it through that book, because he was just the most unlikable character that I have ever read about in my life. He was awful. He should have been a villain. So that was the Grinch tag, and I hope I wasn't too Grinchy for you. If you haven't done this tag, you definitely should. I'm not going to actually verbally tag people, because a lot of people have done this tag, and I was on vacation, so I don't exactly know who has done it. I will tag a few people down in the down bar and on Twitter, so yes, look out for that. You might be tagged, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!